Welcome, YouTubers, to yet another season of Battle Brothers. I am super excited to be back in the hot seat, streaming this all live for you. And I literally cannot wait to get started. But before we dive in, I want to give a shout out to all of the new viewers and subscribers of the channel, all of the continued supporters, all of the comments, all of the likes, all of the extra subscriptions that you guys have come forth with is just incredible for me. I really appreciate all the love and support you show me. It really means the world to me, guys. Thank you so much for being here. I know I haven't had a chance to stream much at all of anything recently, but I am back now and we're going to be going long. So get yourselves a drink. Shut the curtains, turn the lights off, do whatever it is you have to do to get ready because you are in for a doozy of a ride. I can't put my finger on what it is about this game that's so much fun that I enjoy playing so much, but having spent over 2,000 hours on this title and still going, I have to say I just love it. That being said, this might well be the very last run of Battle Brothers I ever stream. I am looking to put the title behind me and pick up some other games. But I figured we'd get one last good run in before that happened. We are going to be playing as the Northern Raiders today in this run. I fancied something different. I normally go for the Band of Poachers, but I didn't want to keep doing the same start over and over again. So yeah, I decided to go with Northern Raiders because I quite like the start. Of the Northern Raiders. It's more interesting because you start raiding straight away, so it just seems a bit more fun, a bit more chaotic, a bit harder perhaps, or a stronger incline on the difficulty gradient, I suppose, at the start of the game. But yeah, I guess before we do anything, guys, we should check out the builds for this run that we're going to be using, which are here. So the seed we're going to be using is this one. I've chosen this seed just because I like the layout of the map. The bros in it aren't particularly powerful and not particularly great, but I think the monk that you start with has quite high resolve on this seed that I've chosen, so that's quite good because he's obviously going to be our bannerman. But yeah, so we've got tanks. They're going to be either heavy tanks or light tanks, carrying spare shields in their bags because shields tend to get broken, and you obviously want to carry a spare to keep their defense up. You always want at least 40 resolve on all your bros. 40 resolve is the minimum resolve you should be aiming for on your bros. That's like the very lowest it needs to be. It should be higher than that, but as a minimum, aim for 40. Then you go defense, health, when you're leveling up, I mean, this is. You go defense, health, and then fatigue or initiative, depending on if they're heavy or light. So if they're heavy, you go for fatigue every time. If they're light, you go for initiative. Up to a reasonable point. I like that point to be around 135 initiative. And then after that, you start getting fatigue for light tanks as well, because light tanks also need fatigue. And then these are the 10 perks you give them, obviously. And again, you go down the left-hand side if they're the heavy tank, or you go down the right-hand side if they're the light tank. So, for example, light tanks get nimble and dodge instead of battle-forged and brawny. Then we've got the sniper, pretty straightforward. Sniper is not the most essential of brothers to have, but they're incredibly useful for dealing with necromancers and enemy arbalisters when you're doing the noble fights. So they are a useful unit if you can find them. If you can find a good sniper, this is the build for them. Throwers are pretty much essential. You need at least two throwers wielding axes in order to be able to do the sunken library, because you need to be able to throw axes at the pots when they get raised in order to destroy them. So we're going to be finding two throwers and one sniper. For heavy tank, for tanks even, it's probably good to have about three or four tanks in your roster. The reason why you need three or four tanks is mainly because of unhold fights against northern barbarians in those big chosen camps where they have unholds mixed with enemy reavers and enemy chosen, you need tanks to be able to sit in front of the unholds and overly and continuously span indom in order to keep them locked into position. So that's why you want three or four heavy tanks or light heavy or light tanks. Anyway, two-handers. Again, 40 resolve, then you go attack, defense, and a fatigue or initiative if they're going to be light two-handers. I don't like the light two-hander build very much. I use it only if they don't have enough defense. If their defense is really low, if they've got like no stars in defense and they keep rolling ones, for instance, they're going to have to be an initiative bro because they need that defense from dodge in order to help keep them alive. But generally, by the end of the game, you want most of your bros to be heavy two-handers. Then you got a Bannerman. Ninja. Again, not the most essential of builds, the ninja. But they're incredibly useful during the mid-game for hacking down champions whose armor you want. Or hedge knights in particular. They were also good for taking out Orc Warlords because the Warlord usually has like a two-handed axe or something, and then when they move in, they tend to try and flank. You keep the ninja at the back, they move in towards the ninja, and then the ninja just punctures them three times and they tend to break immediately, or very quickly at any rate, within a couple of turns. And then that stops the Orc Warlord from roaring and rallying his soldiers and also attacking. It just instantly neutralizes the Orc Warlords, making the fight much, much easier when you've got big Orc fights. Then you've got a duelist build. Duelists I love. You give them an Orc weapon, a famed Orc cleaver or Orc axe on a duelist with Brute, for example, or Iron Lungs, is an incredibly powerful combination. They can hack down a chosen in one or two hits if you give them the right weapon along with this build, and they have something like Huge or Brute as well. But yeah, these are the builds we're going to be using, guys. Feel free to take note. Feel free to ask me any questions you have on them. Apart from that, let's get into it. Like I said, we're going to be starting a new campaign. Going to be doing the Northern Raiders. Start with three experienced barbarians, I should say. They are pretty exceptional for starting units, but they're not the best. So we're obviously not going to sacrifice them, but if they die, we're not too bothered about it because they're not going to be late game bros. Then as pillagers, we have a higher chance to get any items from slain enemies as loot. Not too bothered about that. I mean, generally the armor is useful for getting armor in the early game, but apart from that, it doesn't really matter too much. And then the outlaws, starting with bad relations to most human factions, is really penalizing because you can't go anywhere in the north to trade. You can't pick up any bros from half the cities. You pretty much have to go south almost immediately in order to get recruits and equipment. And so in that vein, the late game crisis, normally I'd leave it on random because it doesn't bother me. I'm going to choose the noble war this time simply because that will give us the earliest opportunity to reset our relationships with the factions and get be able to recruit more bros. The sooner you can access all the cities and recruit recruit new bros, the better. Basically, you want to cycle through recruiting brothers as much as you can because more often than not, they're crap. And so you just cycle through, hire every bro that you can afford to hire until you find one that's any good, and then go from there. We're going to be called the Unstoppables because no one's going to stop us. I like this banner as the Unstoppables because there's something unstoppable about the sun, and it's just covered in blood and just looks really cool. So we're going to go for that one. As always, it's going to be expert low. Iron Man, I'm not going to tick Iron Man for one reason, and it's simply because I don't want to get like 100 days into the game and then randomly get ambushed by Alps in the middle of the night in a forest and then have to restart the entire friggin' game from the beginning because of one unfortunate event that's completely beyond your control. That's the only reason why I'm not doing Iron Man. We are going to do Honor Man though. We're not going to load for anything unless we get completely wiped like that situation I just suggested occurs. And we're not going to save scum or do anything other than have a series of saves so that if we do wipe, like 100 days in, after however many hours of play, we can at least load a previous save from a couple of days before and carry the run on. I like my game to be punishing, I like my game to be challenging, but I don't want to have to reset from friggin' hundreds of days in just because of one event. So I don't want it to be overly punishing. And for that reason, we're not going to be doing Iron Man, we are going to be doing Honor Man. This is the map C that I said. Let's get to it. After you and your party killed half of them, the villagers finally submitted. They have submitted to us. They give us all their treasure. We decide to strike out south. If you're interested in reading this, feel free to pause it. I've read this like a million times, so I'm not gonna spend time reading it for you guys. But yeah, we'll strike out south. So, the bros that we've got. We've got Eric the Crusher. He's iron lunged. They've got pretty good attack, pretty good health, pretty good fatigue, pretty good resolve. These bros are pretty good to start with, actually. But the most important part here is this guy's got Brave with 56 and 3 stars in it. He doesn't have the best fatigue, he doesn't have any stars in fatigue, and he's got no accuracy at all. So he's not going to be the best bannerman. But as an early bannerman, he's going to be fine. He'll do nicely. And guys, anyone in chat, if you're interested in having a bro named after yourselves, if you want to become one of these guys, just let me know and I will happily rename them for you. So this Iron Lung guy, I don't really know. I don't really have a class for him at the moment. He doesn't really have enough stats to fit into any particular class. Same for this guy. No particular distinguishing class springs to mind for me when I look at his stats. So for the moment, we're just going to put in Barbarian 2. We're just going to put in placeholders for their names until someone decides they want to be called that person, or until we can put them into a particular build. Barbarian 3. All right, you can have that. Right, the levels, obviously attack. He only rolled a 3 on his initiative. I think attack, defense, and initiative are probably the best things we can go for. The reason why you go for initiative on these early game bros is because they're all wearing light armor. You don't have access to good heavy armor till much later in the game. By that point, these bros are either dead or have leveled up to a high enough level that they can be nimble. So for early game bros, generally you want to go for nimble builds, in which case you want to pump their initiative and get them dodge as soon as possible, because it's really good for defensive purposes. So again, attack. I won't take the 1 defense. I'll take the 3 initiative and I'll take 3 fatigue so you can keep swinging. We're not going to get student. Normally I would get student for bros that I want to put into a specific class. So they level up faster. But in this part of the game, when we've only got this many bros and we don't have much money, we need every advantage that we can get, and therefore I think I'm going to take fast adaptation with this guy, because fast adaptation is easily one of the best perks in the game for early bros. It's also, if you look at this guy's stats, he's going to finish probably, he started on 60 with 2 stars, he's probably going to finish on about, if he survives long enough, on about 85 to 90 skill, which isn't great. You want them to be on about 100 skill for them to be able to hit relatively accurately through and past shields and things like that. So because he's finishing on such a low skill, he's going to need fast adaptation anyway to help him hit, even when he's max level. So we're going to get it for him now. And then, like I said, the second one you want to get is dodge, so that they have much more defense. Barbarian 2. Some people like adrenaline. Adrenaline can be useful. It can really help. I'm not going to lie. I might get it. I might not. I haven't decided yet. But generally, if you keep pumping initiative, your bros have enough initiative that they tend to go before most enemies when the enemies move in on you. So it tends not to be necessary to have adrenaline until much later, at which point you have other bros who can tank or block or kill quickly. So again, it becomes a bit more redundant. So it's just, it can be argued it's a waste of a perk point, because once they're max level, they don't really need adrenaline to be able to survive, whereas at the start it's really useful. So I can see the argument for adrenaline. I'm not going to be using it, I don't think, but I might put on a couple of bros. I like to get other things instead. And also on top of that, if they're using, I think it's 25 fatigue or something for adrenaline, or 20 fatigue to use it, that's like quarter of their fatigue. So if you're using quarter of their fatigue for one or two adrenalines just to get the upper hand going first, that's most of their fatigue gone. And where you don't have recover particularly quickly, you just burn out. And so on top of that, if you build up fatigue, if you're trying to use dodge, then it cuts your initiative down because you've got such high fatigue and you have less defense as well. So I don't know. I'm not sure about adrenaline, how to feel about it. Maybe I'll use it, maybe I won't. But again, attack. Oh, 5 initiative. Very nice, thank you. 2 defense, that's really weak, but I think I'll take the defense over anything else. Let's go again. Nice, 3 defense, 3 attack, and only 3 initiative that time, but that's fine. Same again, fast adaptation and dodge. And then this guy, we're going to be doing the same again. Attack, nice, 3 defense and 4 initiative. 3 attack, 3 defense. Oh, he's got 2 stars in defense, this guy. I didn't notice him. 5 initiative, very good. So this guy, actually, he's got 2 stars in defense. He's going to end up with quite a decent amount of defense. So we're going to put him in the middle and we're going to make him tanky. Tanky barbarian. Hopefully we'll get a shield for him or something. Right, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to save it. Save it over stream. And then, yeah. So, let's look at the map. I can't remember why I chose this map in specific. I think it was just partly the bros, but I also like the fact that the southern states down here are all fairly close. In a lot of other maps, you'll get like a southern state over here, a southern state here, and then a southern state like this corner. And there's so far to travel in between that it makes using them very difficult. Anyway, I mean, the maps don't really matter that much, as long as you don't have huge tongues of water coming up in the middle of the map like you do on a lot of them. It doesn't matter too much. You also start in the very far north, which means we can travel sort of down this way or over this way and see if we can find any caravans to destroy before heading south completely to sell everything that we have, buy supplies and tools, and then pick up some bros. So let's go. We're just going to look for a caravan, really. We basically have to start looking for stuff to kill. The other reason I'm not playing on Iron Man mode is because I don't have any mods installed. I can't figure out how to get the mods working, in all honesty. I've tried downloading them a few times, extracting them, putting them in the folder that they're supposed to go in. I can't work out how to get them working, in all honesty. I'm not that computer savvy, I'm not that tech oriented. And because of that, I don't have any mods enabled. One of the most useful mods you can get for this game is the pause upon enemy sighting mods, which automatically stops the game as soon as you see an enemy. Because I don't have that mod installed, it means we might, if I'm Oh, nice. Trading caravan. Perfect. Because I don't have that mod installed, I might end up accidentally wandering into a group of enemies that I would rather avoid. And that would be bad news bears. So, yeah. Oh, I need to give this guy a weapon as soon as possible so he can be a runner. Are they going to come towards us? Probably not. No, okay. These guys are dangerous. Two spears, one of which is a boar spear with a shield. This guy's going to spear wall before we get to him. Same with him. So we're going to try and come up round this way. Kill these two before they can start stunning us. And then come round and attack from the north, from the top downwards on these guys. Yeah, there you go, spear wall. Come up and stay near, or like in a decent position. Wait. He's going to spear wall. Wait. He might step in. No, they're not. Okay. You step there. Good hit. Step there and decapitate. No, shame. If I go here, this guy will be able to go there. If I go... Oh, I didn't mean to click... Damn it, I meant to click above. I meant to go here. Oh, well. Fuck. Good start. If I'd gone there, that wouldn't have happened. Or might not have happened. He would have had to step. And he wouldn't have been able to do two attacks on me. That's a good misclick to start. Headshot. Very nice. Go here and attack so that he can't get to you. Oh dear, this guy's in a pickle already. This guy needs to die or he's going to do some serious damage with that spear. Hey, nice, headshot. Instant kill. Do I destroy the shield? See, destroying the shield obviously means we'd be able to hit him more, but it has a double-edged sword effect in that he then gets a duelist double attack on me. And on top of that, I also want the shield, so I'm just going to hit into it. Even though it's better to sometimes to destroy the shield, I've decided to hit into it because I want the shield. I'm hoping I'll get it. I could move here and try and break him, but if I don't, he'll double attack and kill the monk. So we're going to wait. You're going to wait until the surround bonus comes in. Oh, there we go. He's done. Good. Easy. Oh, nice. Look at that. Three furs to start off. That's two boar spears, a shield, or a boar spear and a normal spear, a shield. That is a good haul. So I'm going to save that. New save. Save, and we're going to save it as start. Right. I'm not going to be save scumming. I'm going to be saving regularly in case we get crashes or any kind of bug or anything like that. But I'm not going to save scum. Like I said, this is an Honourman playthrough. So, spears are actually really good, better than the weapons that we have at the moment because they give you plus 20 accuracy. See, plus 20% chance to hit, it says there at the bottom. So when our since our attack is so low at the moment, it's actually really good having spears. It's really useful. Your accuracy is too low to do anything but try and stun people, so take that. And then this guy got a level. Oh, no, I forgot to assign this guy's perks. Oh, shit. That's hilarious. Okay, well, whatever. This guy's probably going to be a bit of a light tank. He's going to be quite tanky. So we're going to go with, instead of fast, although he does have... good attack. So I might not waste him. And he's not... His defense isn't high enough to make him a complete tank. But it's also not high enough for him to be a two-hander. But he also has good attack. So it's not worth making him just a tank. I think we're just going to... Yeah. We'll do the same as we did with the other guys. We'll just make him an offensive unit that can kill quickly, but is probably going to die fairly soon, and we don't really care that he does. Good. Okay. Right, now I'll save it as start, since I've actually assigned his perk points. And we're going to carry on. We're going to see if we can find some more caravans to destroy. Dozen men. Bond of friendship. What's this? Raid 4 trade of... I think we're going to do that. Because that's, you know, our starting... Yeah, that's basically us. What we orient around is our starting background. Okay, so we've got the militia here. And we've got 7 mercenaries coming behind them. There's no way we can take on... We might have been able to take on these guys, but even then it would have been difficult with 7 of them, with a militia veteran there. The mercenaries we definitely can't take. So we're going to swing down through here and come this way and get carry on back on the road. The reason why you want to stay on the road is because you want to fight the caravans. That was close. They almost caught us. You want to fight the caravans. You want to find and kill caravans as much as possible. Just come over past this mountain, and then we're going to lose them because they're going to get pulled onto the mountain range as we go around and onto the road. Or not. They're just going to follow perfectly. Okay, that's fine. Well, hopefully we don't run into anything down here. Otherwise, we're going to get sandwiched. And oh, good. Retreat! No, don't... Okay, this is what I'm talking about Iron Man. The pathing on this game is such bullshit that I clicked... If you saw where I clicked go north, as in move away from these caravan, move away from these soldiers. But what happened is, because the road is a faster route to go on, they ran straight into these guys to get onto the road to move north. Because of that, we're basically dead now, because we can't escape. The dogs will run us down faster than we can escape, and these soldiers are going to slaughter us. So we now need to load it. If we've been doing Iron Man... It's really fucking irritating, this game. If we've been doing Iron Man, this would have been run over. It is run over. We have to reload it. But the reason why we have to reload it is because the pathing is so bad in this game sometimes. Ugh. There's no way we can win this. We're going to get absolutely slaughtered. And there's no... It really frustrates me when stuff like that happens in Battle Brothers. When you go north and your men go, okay, we're going to go southeast towards the road for 5 minutes. And then we're going to go north. Even if it means running into a group of enemy soldiers that are going to slaughter us. So that's a fantastic flying effing start. I'm not even sure why I'm playing this, just to show you guys how dead we are, I guess. I'm going to kill the dogs at the very least. Die, you fucking dogs. Haha! Okay, now the dogs are dead. I don't care what happens to the soldiers. Whatever. Let's load. First load on our Honor Man. Fucking amazing. Great. So yeah, I'll show you. We were down here. Right? We were just here somewhere. The soldiers were coming from here. I clicked up here in order to move our soldiers this way, away from the oncoming soldiers. But the AI goes, oh, it's faster to get here if we come down this way, up this road, along here, and then down here. So instead of going straight north, the way that I wanted them to go to move away from these soldiers, my party ran straight into the soldiers this way and got trapped. Which is really fucking irritating. So we're just going to do the same thing again. Except we're just going to come straight... Okay. Caravans. Fruit from a tree. Going to save it again so we've got that... what's it called? We've got this done. And then we're just going to come straight down the way that we were. And carry on. There goes the mercenaries. That really fucked me off, because I don't want to save scum at all. I said I wasn't going to save scum, but we literally just lost and we'd have to restart anyway. Simply because of the piss poor pathing. Right. Hopefully that company that we ran into is gone now and we can carry on. It looks like there's a trade caravan or something up here. This is dangerous. Going into the woods... Like, this is seriously dangerous, because your sight radius at night goes down, and then when you're in the woods, it goes down even more. So, I can't tell you the number of campaigns that have ended from just being ambushed in the woods at the very start. Now, a supply caravan, we're not going to be able to defeat because they're far too friggin' powerful. I was hoping it was just a normal trading caravan. It isn't. It's an entire supply caravan. We can't defeat it. We're just going to ignore it and go past it. Going to carry on down this way. We're going to make our way down to the lands in the south where we can hire bros, purchase tools, sell everything that we have, make a bit of money by picking up contracts from towns. That's disappointing that was a supply caravan and not a normal trading caravan. I'm playing on the slower speed because I don't want to get caught by anyone. See, again, we're going to try and get these guys to come round. Because we need to get the caravan that's just up ahead. In order to do that, we have to choose the pathing very fucking carefully. Because sometimes it just chooses to be... Oh, they got wrecked. The trading caravan that we wanted to kill got wrecked. You can see the battle there. These assholes didn't come out and protect it, but they're chasing me off good enough, aren't they? Oh shit, they almost caught us. Go, 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 go. Shit, that caravan in the north, or that party in the north might catch us. No, okay, they're slowing down now they're on the mountains. Okay, we'll lose them in the woods now. We should be fine. Oh, it looks like there's someone else on the road ahead. While marching down the road, you find a man with a broken cart. Take what you want. Alright, take everything you can from the cart. You gain bread. Mm, fucking great. Should have helped him. You get better stuff if you help him and your relations improve. I don't know, who was it we nicked from? Okay, probably... We're hostile with these guys, threatening with these guys, and neutral with them, so... Yeah. Don't know who we robbed from, but who cares? Let's keep moving. Okay, looks like whatever was on the road was some kind of company, and it seems to have chased after the beasts, so we're going to ignore it and just keep moving. We don't want to fight beasts at this moment. They'll tear us to shreds. We don't want to fight any kind of company that can move off the road and attack beasts because they'll be too powerful for us to kill. Another supply caravan, but it's from the house that we're ally or friendly with, so we don't want to attack it anyway. At the start of the game, you're looking for as cheap a bros as you can possibly get. So beggars and the like. How many days? We've got 9 days of provisions. We don't need any more provisions. Tools are expensive here. We're not going to buy them. Yeah, I don't need anything else. Selling is no good here because we're not ambush trade routes. So we're just going to move on. We want to go to Lightmark because Lightmark might have ambush trade routes and it's a big city. So when you sell there, you'll make lots of money. And that's what we want to do. We need to get our crowns up. I'm just going to pop into Sonheim en route, see if we can pick up a cheap. 6 brigands. No, I'm not. We can't defeat 6 brigands with only 4 of us. Actually, we might be able to since this guy is a runner. Some of them might go after them. The thing is, we don't have any daggers either yet. So even if we fight brigands, we're not going to be able to get their armor, and it's just a bit too dangerous. So I'm actually going to run away from that. We need to be fighting thugs for like the first couple of days, at least, to get some bit more equipment. Another supply caravan. Oh, here we go, instead of a trading caravan. Fuck me, though. They got 10 and 11 caravan hands. Where are the sixers? You need, like, to be able to fight the same number of soldiers as you have. Here we go, ambush trade route. So we're going to be able to sell for a decent sum. Sell that. Sell, sell, sell. Sell, sell, sell. We're at 2.7k. That's much more like it. Right. You want cheap bros, so this guy, you basically just want bodies to fill out, provide adjacency bonus, fill out your roster, provide adjacency bonuses, and yeah, block, body block, essentially. 120 is really expensive for a cripple, so I'm not going to pay for him. You want them to be like 20 crowns or whatever. 270 for a caravan hand is really good. That's a really cheap caravan hand, and we want a caravan hand. The reason why is because if you get them to level 7 and keep them for long enough, they'll upgrade your inventory for free, and that gives you more inventory space, which is really useful. So we're going to hire the caravan hand. The cripple is absolutely useless. It's got low initiative, low resolve, no hit points. I mean, I expected him to be useless, so this guy is just trash. We're just going to let him die at some point. Doesn't matter what happens to him. This guy, the other reason why I hired him is he comes with a dagger, so, or a knife, so he can start puncturing people and try and get their armor. 52 attack isn't bad, but I mean, his stats are just meh. He's not really anything. He's completely irrational as well, so, you know, he's going to be our caravan hand. We're going to try and keep him alive. We're going to use him. But he's probably, yeah, we're going to use him and try and keep him alive. But there's no guarantee that that will happen. 105 and 95. 65 and 50. 75 and 40. Swap those so that you've got the most armor. So armor, less armor. Trash can go in front with another club. This guy's going to try and dagger people down. Yarp. With 6 bros, you need more like 8, really, to be able to start doing follow the tracks, quests, contracts. Gravedigger for 70 is really good. Gravediggers have got loads of fatigue. So for 170, I'm going to hire him. He's actually pretty good. Hopefully he'll be pretty good, but generally. Yeah, see, look how much fatigue they start with. 107. He is meh. So, good hit points. Yeah, he's fine. Nothing special. He's got 2 stars, so rather than trash, I'm going to make him a meat shield. Hopefully he'll live long enough to prosper. Where's the priest? Here we go, early banner. Yarp. Drive off brigands and moldy shelter. No, thank you. What's this worth to you? Follow the tracks for 260. This is the contract that we want to be doing. Problem is it's going to be 7 brigands. Or 7 thugs, even. We only have 7 of us ourselves, so I'm not sure, I'm not confident we can win it without being, especially because we're going to be trying daggering people down. What we want to do, ideally, is pick up some nets if we can. Nets are really useful, really powerful in the early game. Wait, how much was that armor? 2, I thought it was 22. I was like, geez, that's cheap armor. I shouldn't be shopping here. Everything's really expensive because it's Amish trade route, so we're not going to buy here. We are going to move down to Kraken and see if we can find some more beggars, a few bodies. With 7 of us, we might... Oh, the conscripts are really powerful, actually. I was going to say we should be able to take on this trading caravan, but it's from the protectorate of Karak, whatever this place is. So for one thing, we don't want to piss them off. Secondly, I'm not even convinced we could win the fight against that many conscripts. Flavius, my man. The boys are back in town. They are indeed. Welcome to the stream, my friend. Long time no see. I hope you are well. 4 outlaws. This could be really profitable for us, or they could just completely wreck us. Yeah, I don't know. I'm really tempted to do the fight, but the chances are they are going to completely wreck it. If they have like a pole mace, they'll absolutely destroy us. We'll go and attack them and hopefully get some high ground that we can utilize for the fight. But yeah, if they have like a pole mace, which they do, and a cleaver, yeah, they're going to absolutely fucking destroy us. I think we retreat up to here and use this high ground up here. And that doesn't help. They're faster than us in armor than this dum-dum. We're not going to be able to get there, I don't think. Maybe we will because of the height differential. Yeah, oh no, there we go. He's already caught us. Oh, this is a disaster. It was all going so well as well. They're on the high ground. They've got a pole mace on the high ground. This guy's dead. We just have to sacrifice him. Yeah, we have to sacrifice him, which is a really bad fucking start. There's no way we're getting him free. I thought maybe I could stun this guy and run, but now the other guy's joined. To try and... Yeah? Oh, I stunned one of them. Splat. Instant splat. And now they're going to move up here and catch... No, they didn't because he was stunned. Okay, that's fine. Go there. Come here. Go there. You go there. You go here. Right, let's see what they do. We've already got a 10% penalty there because of the fucking fear. Because he's scared, he's shitting himself. Lucky that missed. Is this guy still to go? His turn's done. I think we just hold position. Unfortunately, that means the pole mace is going to go here and just start swinging on this guy. This guy will probably go here rather than there. Just wait. You can come down and try and stun. You can shield wall. You might as well just attack because you've got nothing else to do. Wait. There's no point waiting because... Yeah. If I go here, this guy will come down there. So come to here and finish. Finish there. Yeah, he's coming up that way. Oh, interesting. The pole mace went there. I guess because this guy's got no shield. All good, expecting a baby at the end of January. Mate, that's awesome. Beginning of February, so just enjoying the small amount of free time I have left. Mate, that's awesome. Congratulations. I'm stoked for you. I'm good, mate. Yeah, I'm all good. I've been really busy with work. I've got a promotion again at work, so more responsibility, less free time, and more tired when I get back from work, hence why I haven't been online for so long. But yeah, I'm glad to be back. Do you know what? I genuinely don't know what to do here. This is just fucked up, this situation. Like, completely fucked up. This guy needs to go against the cleaver guy, but we're going to get wrecked no matter what we do. Could go here. No, come up here. Dead. And that's our bannerman as well. Oh, a nice couple of headshots, that was lucky. Oh, thanks, mate. Congrats on the promotion. Yeah, I really appreciate that. Come on, boys, you need to hit your attacks or you're fucked. You're probably. Oh, good stun. Very nice. Oh, I needed fatigue to stun this guy. He's got a broken arm anyway, so he's dead. That was lucky the first one missed, but still, we are just fucked here. Lucky couple of hits. Everyone's running. Oh dear, oh dear. And that's game. Let's start again. Fuck. New campaign. Northern Raiders. Unstoppables. Yeah, it was risky attacking those what's it called? Those nomads, because the weapons could have been anything. If one of them had a whip or something instead, then we'd have been doing much better. Instead of a pole mace, for example. But that, it was just a gamble. I knew it was a gamble attacking them. Attack, defense. Not defense, because it's only one. We'll take the 4 hit points. So, fast adaptation and dodge, same as before. This guy gets attack, 5. And we'll take 2 defense. Fast adaptation. That. And initiative again, and dodge. And this guy gets attack, defense, and initiative. Attack, defense, and initiative. Fast adaptation and dodge. Alright. This guy becomes the Ali Banner. I won't bother renaming the other guys because I don't have any builds for them, any classes. Our company is about to be brought to a huge old money family. Interesting times ahead. Oh, really? So, they're just buying you out and changing everything around, or... I guess you don't know. That's quite interesting. Cool. Let's go down this route like we did before, and see if that caravan spawns again, because I think it should. I can't remember where he fought it last time. Maybe not. I guess you get different events. Same seed, but different events. Yeah. Okay. That's a shame. That was a really good start with those furs. We picked up shitloads of money. Okay, well, there's a watchtower here which we're not going to be able to get past. I don't think. Actually, we got past it. Oh, no. Nope. Fuck! Fuck! Run! There's 25 men after us. Fucking leg it. I thought it was weird that nothing had spawned. I was like, why has nothing spawned from anywhere? They should be... Oh, there they are. Just as they came out. Okay. That's unfortunate. So we didn't get the caravan this time like last time. Friendship, I think, is the easiest one to do out of all of the... Oh, no, there we go. Caravans. We'll do the caravan one because that's our origin. We'll go down this way, but then these guys are going to spawn them as well. We're literally trapped between two massive citadels, which haven't spawned any caravans. That's frustrating. Last Friday, they sent the official letter. Their target is for us to be integrated fully in their structure. I see. Okay. Your job secure. Good. I was going to ask that. Are you confident that they're not going to start laying people off and stuff? As I'm just a service owner, regardless of the direction, they will still have to work for me. Brilliant. That's awesome, mate. Oh, fucking hell. This is a really bad start compared to the last time. Last time we got a caravan instantly. This time we've had to go off the road because they've spawned military companies instantly instead. Look, this is what I mean. Look at the pathing. For fuck's sake. It's lucky we didn't get caught again. It's because they want to go round the swamp because it's faster to get back on the road going round the swamp than... No. Okay, we're stuck. We're fucked. Oh, evasive maneuvers! Look at that. Now we go into the woods and we lose them in the woods. Shikaka! Yeah, fuck you, assholes. We're out of here. Another military company coming out there. We're looking for bloody something to kill. Anything we can fight with four men would be nice. So Flavi, your baby, do you know if it's going to be a boy or a girl? Have you found... Oh, there we go, trading caravan, perfect. Have you found that out yet? Are you one of the people who doesn't want to know until the day comes? Cops and robbers, yeah. Hide in a bush. Oh, they're going to have high ground as well. Are you fucking kidding? This start, man. This start has been bad. Although he's got a dagger, that's good. Maybe we'll get the dagger with any luck. Yeah, you step off that high ground, it's my high ground. We want this guy's armor, but there's no way to get it. We just have to hope we get headshots on him. Yeah, step there and shield wall, why don't you? See, this guy can't get through, so he's going to have to move on to the high ground, so you're going to stay there. Screw that noise, I wanted to know. Cool, so which is it, boy or girl? What have you got brewing in the oven? Do we go here or do we go here? I think we go here. Because then we can get an attack off. If we go here, this guy can go there. And it's the same thing. Yeah, let's go here. He'll go here. No, he went there. Okay. Oh, that guy went there. Weird. Fine with me. Kill him. Don't know why I attacked when I'm waiting for the adjacency bonus. That should have been a kill. That's annoying. Thank goodness he didn't stun. Bled to death. Good. Ow! Okay, there's a chance this guy's going to die, so we need to break him. Oof, lucky. Good. Good. Broke him. That was close. Oh, we got the headshot as well, which means we didn't get the armor, damn. And this time we just got three loaves of bread instead of all that good fucking fur we got last time. That's annoying. Boy, congratulations. His name will be Arthur Sebastian. Mate, I love it. I love it. That's awesome. I'm so stoked for you. Congratulations. We didn't get any shield either. Fuck sake. Who's got the highest attack? You do. You get the dagger, the boar spear. 64 and 64, you get that spear. You can have the axe now instead. The axe and the buckler. I don't really like bucklers, but it's better than not having anything, I suppose. That's going to be all of our tools and supplies now. Yep, all our tools and supplies just to repair from that fucking... That fight didn't go as well as it could have done, as the other one did, and we didn't get as good loot. Is this your first, by the way, as well? Your first little one? We got six brigands. Oh, luckily the company came out and chased them off. Okay. Looking for cheap bros, like super cheap. None of these guys are particularly cheap. None of them are particularly useful. So we're not going to hire any of them. We're just going to move on. What we want is somewhere we can go Lichtmark. That's where we need to sell. We need to go to Lichtmark to sell for ambush trade routes. That was really unlucky. We came all the way over here and then all the way down this way. Came all the way through how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, kind of 6 cities and didn't get a single fucking caravan to conquer apart from that one that we just got, which gave us nothing but fucking moldy bread. It's bullshit, yo. That's just the game for you, though. The game, especially on Raiders, is very difficult at the start. You need to get a good start. None of this is that useful for us. 80 for a bro. I will take it. I prefer it being more like 40 or 20 for a cripple, but... Oh, hello. This is what I'm talking about. This guy cost us 80, and he's got the same stats, nearly, as one of these guys, who would have cost like 400 or something to start with. His attack's low, yes, but he's got great defense, or he will do. Lots of fatigue. He's going to be a great meat shield. And he only cost us 80. Guy healed yet? Yeah, good. That's 20. This is 20 as well, isn't it? Yeah, so it doesn't really matter what he wears. Okay, next place. We're going to be looking for bros who are super cheap, basically, because we've got absolutely no money. Yeah, you're first. A bit scared, but super excited. Mate, I'm sure you'll be fine. It's always daunting. Or not daunting. Daunting's the wrong word. Nerve-wracking going into something new. A new adventure is always going to make you a bit anxious and a bit uncertain, but I'm sure you'll be fine. And, yeah. It'll be a great adventure, so kudos to you, mate. Okay, so we've got a servant for 70. He's hired. We've also got a caravan hand for 150. He's definitely hired. For the same reasons I spoke about the caravan hand just now. And then Hugo the rat catcher. Rat catchers have insanely high fatigue, but he's actually quite expensive for what we've got. The servant is nothing, club-footed and pessimistic. He's just trash. But again, the caravan hand came with a dagger, and he's pretty fucking okay. High initiative, good fatigue. I mean, he's not anything solid, but... You only paid 110 for him, so... Yarp. You're going to go there. We really need some money. For the right price, we'll find it. Perfect. Find ancient ruins some way to the west. We're going to do that for 320. We definitely want to do that. And then follow... No, drive off the brigands. We can't do that quite yet. We need a couple more bros. Find ancient ruins some way to the west. Yes, please. Yeah, whatever, I'll think about it. Just having a refreshing drink. If we go up this mountain, we should be able to see it. Yeah, there we go. So you got 8 brigand thugs there. Ancient ruins. They didn't come from the ancient ruins. They came past beyond it. So we don't know what's in the ruins. 8 thugs is a bit too many for us. We can only handle 7 at the moment. Maybe even less. 6. So we're going to head back to town, get the money, and then just carry on. Trading caravan, but it's from Dornheim, which we don't want to piss these guys off, because it's the only place we can actually get tools from. I can't remember what happens if you do this. Why get paid only once if we can get paid twice? Let's try it. Oh, nice. You tell the man that you'll keep the location of his familial home a secret. While he celebrates, you go and tell Igmar the Wise where the ancient ruins is. Getting paid by both sides makes for a pretty sweet gig. Catching hate from both, not so much. But what do they expect in dealing with a sellsword? These people will never learn. So you got 700, but we made Dornheim threatening to us. That's fine. I needed the money, and Dornheim will get over it. Let's come down to Sonheim. Actually, let's go to Krakendorf, where now we've got a bit of money. We might be able to buy some nets. On top of that, there's that caravan down here that was from Dornheim as well. We can go and attack it. Now that Dornheim's already pissed off at us. We just don't want to piss off the Noble House. We don't want the Noble House to get so angry with us that they don't want to do business with us everywhere that we go in the south. 4 peasants from Krakendorf. Yeah, we want to attack this. Hopefully they'll be carrying something good on it. You can hide because I forgot to give you, because you don't actually have a weapon. Don't want you dying. Yeah, the main bros can handle this. The main three. Oh my goodness, that is a lot more than I thought. Maybe not. I didn't realize there were seven of them. Oh, this could be a pickle. This could be a real pickle. This is really scary, actually. Trash can come with us. You can come up as well. I didn't realize there were seven of them. We're going to try and use this bush to our advantage. I don't know how, because he's just going to sit there spear walling like a moron for like the rest of eternity. So I don't know how we're going to close the distance. We haven't got a shield yet. Yeah, he's just going to keep doing that until he's exhausted. So we're just going to wait until he's run stams out, basically. If only we had a flail. None of these bastards have any helmets. Okay, there we go. So he's stammed out now, so you can come up to here. I really wish he had a shield. Go there and spear wall. And then start the attack. Go there and spear wall. Come here. I'm just going to one-on-one it, basically. Got no choice right now. Come here. The dagger guy we want down here so he can try and dagger down this guy. Although he's got a shield, so we want to dagger down him, probably. We'll wait. We'll see where this guy goes, this cleaver guy goes. They're not fucking... No, that's a bad idea. 54% chance for the decap. Oh, he missed it. He fucking missed it. Shield wall again, spear wall again, finish, spear wall again, finish. Aha, back you fool. Why is this guy morale? Oh, he must have stepped in and made this guy's morale go down. That's really irritating. Okay. Oh, lucky that missed. Do we step and attack? No, I don't want the early banner to die. Good puncture, we got the pierced hand, so now he's got reduced melee effectiveness. Spear wall again and finish. Don't kill my caravan, dude, I need him. Keeps missing this guy. He's just being beaten to death by a guy with a club. funny. I really want to take this high ground with someone, but I just don't know how I can. Come round. Come down. Actually, you come there. Yeah, I can let the spear wall do its work on these dummies. I don't know why he's insisting going here when he could come up here and attack this guy, but no friggin' problem. Oh, we got the puncture. That was lucky. Pierced his side. If we go here, these guys can surround him, but he's on high ground, so he should be okay. He'll step down and attack. Yeah. I don't know why they're obsessed with going on this square, but I'll take it. 8% chance to hit. Let's bump him back, actually. So he has to keep spear walling. 48% chance to hit. There's no point just to wait. Oh, I can't spear wall again, actually. Wait. Oh, this guy's in trouble. Oof, lucky that missed. Please, please, for the love of God, hit this guy. 56%? Oh, no, 76. We'll go for the... I don't know which one to go for. If we go... they're both just as risky, but he'll just step in. No, his turn's done. Less chance of hitting this guy, but it'll possibly kill him if it does. It probably won't kill him, but it'll be a... if he gets a headshot, it'll kill him. This guy's still got to go, yeah, so he can kill him, so... yeah, there you go, headshot. And it broke this guy's morale. Stay there. Go for the double stab. Go for the kill, yeah, nice. And this guy's broken now, so wait there. Go for the kill, double miss. Go for the punctures, wait. For the surround bonus. We probably want to step in here now. No, we want him to... well, I don't want him to step in and get this guy, actually. So, yeah, meat shield can do his job. I don't want to step there because it's like a triple surround. Step there and just wait. Wait, because we want the armor. Wait, because we want him to go. You're basically done. Who has the dagger? It's you. This guy has the dagger. Do I put the dog down? I think so, because they don't attack dogs anymore like they used to. Dogs no longer provide adjacency bonuses, but they also don't attack the dog like they used to. They attack the human instead. So there's no point really putting the dog down, actually, because he'll just tear through the armor and be a nuisance. So let's just wait. Ow. Good. Oh, the armor's basically gone now anyway. Good headshot. Nice, we got it. That was fucking terrifying. Who's got the... not this guy, it's this guy who's got it, isn't it? You have it. Yeah, nice. Maybe we'll get the armor, I doubt it, but... it's worth a try. Nice. Hey, look at that. Good haul. We didn't get the armor, we got the helmet though, we got a boar spear, we finally got a shield. Shame we didn't get that leather armor, that laminar armor would have been really nice. Now the next question is, are they pissed off with me? Enough to attack me? No, they're just cold. Okay, all good. Meat shield, you're fine. Caravan man can take the 50. The helmet can go on. Who's the defensive guy? This guy. Tanky barbarian. Oh, he has 105 anyway, doesn't he? Yeah, that's 105 helmet, so... Iron Lungs guy can get this. He's got the lower armor, actually, of the two. That's 75, isn't it? So swap. There we go. Right, then this is 65 and 30. No, 65 and 50. That's only a 50, and that's a 20. Okay. Take that. Take that. You take that. And you, I don't really care about. You can have the club. Yeah. Meat shield can go for the stun. Is that reduced? No, he just has 44 attack. Hey Caesar, nice to see you playing Battle Brothers. Have fun, mate. Robin, thank you so much for joining. Thank you for the comment. Appreciate it. Hope you're doing well today, mate. Enjoy the stream. Let's see. Let's go to Krakendorf like I wanted to. See if we can get any more bros and any nets. Nah, they're all quite expensive for what they're offering. And there's no nets here for some reason. Perfect. Okay. Anything else worth buying, though? No, not at this moment. Let's go down to New Dich. Pay for a round of drinks to improve morale. A day teller for 90. It's on the edge of being worth it, but we'll hire him because we're in desperate need of bros. We'll sell the meat because it's going to go off. That'll pay for the bro we just hired. 234 for tools. It's not the cheapest I've seen, but we need tools, so I might buy. Oh, hello! A 90 crown day teller. Sitting there on triple star melee skill, triple star health, and triple star fatigue. All right. He's only got 49 in attack, so he's not going to be anything phenomenal by the time he finishes. But if we can keep him alive and rank him up, he'll be a good backliner. But, I mean, backliners are worth shit. I know that. He's trash, don't get me wrong, but, you know, he might equate something good. Good enough for a mid-game bro if he keeps rolling fours on his attacks. He's got good initiative as well. Cryo Jester, what's up, my man? Welcome to the stream. Thank you for joining. I hope you're well. Did I check for nets here? I can't remember. No, I didn't, but they don't have any. Not getting much luck here. All right, let's just move on. We got 8 men though, actually. We might be able to do a follow the tracks. Yeah, for 240, follow the tracks. How are we looking in terms of health and armor? 83% on you. You're just a meat shield. With 8 bros, we could probably do the follow the tracks. It'll be difficult though, without any nets, to get any armor. Do I want to go to another city and get more bros, or do I want to do the follow the tracks? Is there any place for my name in the company? There is, Cryo Jester. Where would you like to... Out of all the bros we have, these 3 barbarians are the only ones that we're going to be keeping for the long term. And then we've got the early banner as well. If you want, you can be the bannerman. Or you can be one of these trash units which are going to die off fairly quickly. It's up to you, mate. Let me know which one you want. Caravan Man is going to be with us for a while. Because we want to get him to level 7 and then keep him in the back so he upgrades the inventory. You got Eric the Crusher. He's got iron lungs. Then we got Tanky Barb, who's got good defense, but nothing else really going on for him. And then we got Hellheimer, who's fat right now. And again, he just had decent attack, but nothing special really about him. Well, Cryo Jester decides on who he wants to be named as. I'm just going to go turn the lights on quickly, chat. I'll be right back in a second. Since it's getting dark and gloomy in here in good old England. It's 4 o'clock in the afternoon and it's almost pitch black in here. Can you name a cannon fodder after me? Yeah, of course, Robo. No worries. Anyone in particular? Let's see. Rudolph, we just got. He might be pretty good. He's got good attack. Meat Shield is a cripple. A survivor cripple. He's going to be going strong, actually. I reckon we'll have him towards the end because he's going to have good defense and health. Well, no, I'm lying. He's going to die pretty quick. And then we've got Club-Footed Servant, who's pessimistic. Any preference? You don't care, he'll die. Fair enough. We'll give you the Club-Footed Servant. Roban. Congratulations. Welcome to the team. Let's do the follow the tracks. Oh, they've run across onto the island. That's a nuisance. Hopefully they won't run all the way up here. They'll just stop it. Yeah, there we go. They stopped and they're coming back. Many thugs. Yeah, no problem. Or not necessarily no problem, but exactly what we were expecting. Okay. Unfortunately, this guy's missing a lot of health still. I don't like that, but we'll just have to hope that he survives. Whoops. All of these guys are kind of valuable, but not really. Sounds like me, thank you. No worries, you're welcome. Okay, let's go. Thieves, let's do it. And if we die and... Oh, look at this. Nice. This is a nice, easy... None of them have any spears. The only plus accuracy weapon is that sword. And, well, we don't know what's in here yet, actually. Let's see what's in here first. But this guy has no armor at all. This guy has no armor at all. They might come towards us as well because we outnumber them. I want this surcoat, so you're going to come down here and try and dagger him down. Oh, shit. I didn't realize this guy's armor was completely fucked. I thought this guy was the only person missing health. This guy has no armor. Oh, I may have botched it, guys. Oh, we can't use this guy at all, really. He's just got no armor. He's got the dagger as well. Shit sticks. I really want to dagger that guy down, but that sword will completely ruin him. Let's see what they do. They're coming. Yeah, they are coming towards us. Okay, well, this could be fine because they're coming towards us. Step there, spear wall. We want to kill this guy as quickly as possible. But we also don't want to be silly about things, so let them come to us. Okay, just a club, that's good. What does this other guy have? Oh, he does have a spear. Okay, and he's dual wielding as well, so that's quite scary. But we spear walled him back, so... I kind of... Oh, shit, I didn't mean to skip. Bollocks, I meant to attack that guy. Luckily, he's only got a shit one... He's only wielding one-handed a wooden shitty stick with a twig on the end, so... Should be okay. Let's see. We want this guy to step in. Again, this guy's got no friggin' armor. Oh, man. Wait. Everyone wait and let them do what they're gonna do. Yeah, double miss. He'll step in and then go for the stun. No, he went for the attack. Eesh. 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 Scary times. This guy's going next. We want him to step in. We want to surround this guy as quickly as possible. So go there. Oh, bollocks. Go there. We don't want these guys to surround this bottom guy. So come here and go for the Bosch. Yeah, good, so they're coming up now. Okay, so we're going to surround this guy and dagger him down before he can do anything. Yeah, this guy's dead. Ooh, that was fucking lucky. 61. Yep, dead. Ouch. That was our bannerman. That was the early banner. He's killed early banner. He died as well. He didn't get struck down. Well, this is not going well at all. Crow Jess, a long time to see you, buddy. How have you been? Roman, welcome to the damn squad. We who are about to die salute you. Indeed we do. You need to come up, otherwise everyone's going to die up here. No, don't destroy the armor. Double miss. Fucking come on. Oh, are you fucking kidding me? Rolls 50s. And I can't get this 45 hit. Yeah, we're in trouble here. Good, that was lucky. Not just lucky, almost essential, in fact. Go there and try and break. No, shame. Oh, fuck. One of the main barbarians died. That's fucking irritating. You fucking prick. We're not even going to get his armor either because the dog's out now and he's just going to hack him up. So, yeah, just kill him. Oh, thank God the bannerman survived with a missing eye. Not the bannerman, sorry. The barbarian survived with a missing eye. That means absolutely nothing to a melee soldier. Thank fuck. We only lost the early bannerman. It's all good, boys. It's all good. 720 crowns? No. I mean, I want the money, but these guys will get hostile with us. And then the entire red faction will get hostile with us. So we're going to return it. Oh, only 240 crown. Maybe I should have taken that, actually. Oh, well. Cryo, did you want anyone in particular? You never got back to me. Ugh, that guy's down. Caravan man gets attack, defense, and initiative. He gets fast adaptation. Meat shield gets... Oh no, sorry. Meat shield gets defense, initiative, and he would get health, but he's only got two. I'm going to give him the four resolve so he holds his ground, because you need 40 as a minimum, really. Get nine lives from meat shield. Yep. Okay. Well, whatever. Right, we're going to come across the Lichtmark and see if we can sell all our shit for some money. Bloodbound mercenaries. So, first Lichtmark company. Seeing a lot of mercenaries and companies on the road as opposed to bloody caravans. That's annoying. Let's stop off in Sondheim. Hey, there's a drought here. Maybe we can sell some food. 77 for the ham. I will take that. In fact, 35 for that I'll take as well, because we've got two more days of food. That can go. These we want to repair, but we don't have any friggin' tools. Tools here are really expensive as well. So is the wine. Any bros for hire? An 80 refugee. We'll take the refugee for 80. And the caravan hand for 160. And see if there's a follow the tracks we can do. No. Oh, we might be able to secure the ruined beekeep, actually. They both came with daggers as well, the other reason why I hired them. Because you basically get the dagger. Well, you do. You get the dagger included in the price. And the dagger itself is worth like 50 crowns. So that takes like half the value back. Half money off. The refugee is trash, like we thought he would be. The farmhand is unfortunately not very good either. He'll be a decent meat shield, but nothing major. So the meat shields, where's the other one? You get, there's no point in having the surcoat because it just doesn't, it's not, we're not going to be able to repair it for a while because we don't have tools. Tanky Barb can get the dagger. Meat shield can have the 40. You get that. Go for the clubs, you can stun. This guy can go for a dagger, maybe part of the daggering team. So at the start, you want like half your troops to have daggers to try and get armor, to try and peel the armor off your enemies. Flails are really good as well. The wooden flails, not so much. They're a bit shit. But as soon as you get the tier 2 flails onwards, you can start bopping down raiders' heads. And that gives you the armor, obviously, which is what you want. I would do this, but we're just too damaged. We need to go buy tools. In order to afford tools, we need to go and sell everything we have at Lichtmark, which hopefully has ambush trade routes still. Yeah, it does. Good. So we can sell here for a pretty penny. I'm not going to buy anything here, though, I don't think. Let's see if we can hire anyone. A thief for 390. Not the cheapest thief I've seen, but he might be really good. Thieves can be really good tanks, so we're going to hire him. He also comes with a dagger again, same as before. So he's worth hiring. I wish he was a bit cheaper, but what can you do? We could get this beggar. He comes with a knife, but for 120, that's quite a lot for a beggar. I'd much rather go for the thief and roll on him. Any good? Yeah, look at this. If he'd had one more star, he'd have made an amazing tank. He's still pretty good with 11 defense. He's a pretty good meat shield. 11 defense and 2 stars in it. I'm happy with that as a meat shield. But we need to get him the equipment because this... He's just going to die immediately at the moment with that. This dagger one of you guys can have. Who's got the best attack? At the moment it's you with 53. Actually, yeah, you take that. Oh, who am I kidding? Let's just try daggering people down with those two. Swordsman goes in. Yeah, we need armor really, so. You know, I'm gonna buy some tools. 25 tools already. Jeez. The 293. I think they were cheaper back here, weren't they? They were like 250 back here in Sondheim. So let's go back to Sondheim and pick up those tools and then see if there's any contracts here that we can do. No, not worth it. Drive off brigands. Meh. Not really. What does it pay to find somewhere? Some way to the northeast. Yeah, we'll do that. We'll go buy tools and then come and do this. That'll give us time to repair and pay for everything we're about to do. So I know it's up over this way. We're just going to come over here to Sondheim, pick up some tools quickly, and then head back. Oh, they're the same price. For fuck's sake, whatever. Fucking tools in this game piss me off so much. Let's go. We're going to need food as well, so that's extortionate price, but whatever. Let's go south, northeast and find this. Much appreciated, whatever. How are we looking now? So that's getting repaired. Good, we've also got another 50 here that can be repaired. You just have a pierced side, which, no, I'm not going to use you till that's healed. Oh, okay, that was easy. No. No way we can do that right now. Necromancer with zombies. No thanks. Let's head up to Woolenwacht. Hey, these guys aren't pissed off with us anymore. Not as much. So we can go there for contracts and start building our reputation with them again, which is good. Woolenwacht. No, no. Let's go to Ornwacht. Let's see if we can find any caravans on the road. Trading caravan with 5 people in it. Fucking perfect. Let's get them, boys. They should come towards us because we outnumber them, basically. So let's see what they do. Let's just round it and see if they are coming towards us. Yeah, it looks like they are. Or not. No, they're not. Okay. Right, we need to go towards them then. Oh, we'd really like to dagger this guy down, but I don't know if we'll be able to because he's got a shield. And the forest makes it really hard to get surround bonus. Normally you can step in and stab once or twice with a dagger once you've got dagger mastery, but in the forest it's really hard to do. Especially when you've got all this crap around. They're never going to run because they have to protect the donkey. So I think we just send the barbarians north to kill this guy. And then the dagger people, like, down this way? I don't know. Let's see what they do. Yeah, they're just going to do that until they stab out. So this will be a little bit of a long battle. Let's just end round because they're going to spear wall again. Same again, round it. Just keep doing it until he runs out of stamina, basically. Which he will eventually. One more round and then should be good. Okay, just wait now this time and he'll probably step backwards actually because he won't be able to spear wall. I'll probably step to there. No, you didn't. Okay, weird. Guy's only got a dagger. Yeah, he broke. Okay, I don't like his positioning at all. His position's really annoying because I'm trying to dagger him down. That's what I want. I might be able to get him to come in here and then I can surround him. He'll probably go there, actually, though, which I kind of want. Because then I can surround him really well. I can get guys all around here if he goes there. So let's just wait, see what he does. Yeah, he went there. Okay. So now we need to get... Now is the tricky part. We need to get him surrounded. You're done, because you've got no more armor. Charge, men! Sally forth! Surround him! Good puncture. Very nice. I don't actually have a dagger for him, so you're just waiting. You're gonna go there. You're gonna go there. Nice, almost broke him. Ow! What are the odds of that? 61, actually pretty high. This guy's dead. This is what I mean about trying to dagger him down. This is what you need nets for. I was hoping he'd break. There we go, he broke. He did break eventually. Right, now we just dagger him down. Garbage died, but no one cares. Nice bit of loot, lots of meat and stuff. That's good. We needed supplies, actually. We needed provisions, so that's really good. I would have preferred stuff to sell, obviously, like hides or whatever, but... Okay, now we give them all daggers. All these boys get the good daggers. 56, 44, yeah. Let's see, shields. Oops, shield for him. Meat shield can now get that and that. This guy can get that and that. Needs a 40s, aren't they? This guy can get a 40 and he's got a 55. Good. Dagger. We've got a nice little dagger squad going on. You can... How long before this heals? 1 to 4 days. Yeah, hopefully it'll be 1 rather than 4, but who knows. Notice how I'm not giving these guys armor. I could give him the helmet. And I could give him the helmet. But then if they get destroyed, the odds are they're just going to get destroyed and die. So I just leave them as naked troops because they're going to die anyway. So I don't want to waste the armor. I want to keep this armor for someone who'll actually be able to survive with it. It sounds counterintuitive, but it makes sense. Yeah, we really didn't get much out of that, actually. With only five of them, but we got some good armor. Oh, Owen Wacht is now pissed off at us again. They're all pissed off at us again. I was hoping to go up there and do a contract. Let's make a save, because we haven't saved in a while. Let's see if there's another... We can only go as far as this watchtower. But there might be another caravan. Suck it up. Meat shield loses 3 resolve. Alright, whatever. Yeah, there isn't. I was hoping there would be another caravan, but there isn't. For some reason, that hasn't spawned anyone. Don't know. Oh, there we go. Nice. 7 of them. Good. Okay. Right, let's see who can do what. This guy needs a level. Roban gets attack, gets initiative and fatigue, so he can keep stabbing. Fast adaptation, because he's a knife boy. You should be fine. I don't think you'll die. You can get experience by being in the battle. That would be wonderful. Right, there you go. Let's get him. Don't really want any of their armor, actually, so we're just going to kill them. Don't want you to die, so stay back. You can stay back. You can go in. You can come here. I don't want to send the guy who's wounded up onto the high ground. Oops, didn't mean to double click then. Whatever. Ouch. We're seeing if he had a dagger, but he doesn't, so whatever. We need to kill the guy with a spear first. He definitely needs to die. Ouch, that axe hurts as well. Got the puncture. He dead. Easy peasy. Nice. Good bit of loot. That's what I'm talking about. Right, we can go now. Let's get out of here. Let's skedaddle back to Lichtmark Cell again, and then we'll go down south to Karakan and try and pick up some more troops. If this spawns troops now, I'll be so pissed off. No, good. 5 tools and supplies. Did we get anything good out of that? No, we got absolutely nothing. Apart from the loot to sell, we got no weapons. These bucklers, oh, I hate bucklers, they're so pointless. Right. Attack, defense, initiative. I think we go gifted for even more attack, defense, and initiative at this point. Even more attack, defense, and initiative. Very good. Initiative equates to defense because of dodge. Rudolph gets 4 attack. Very nice. If he keeps getting 4 attacks, he'll be absolutely beastly. Initiative for dodge. And he's going to be kind of a meat shield character because he's got so much health. So we're going to give him, instead of defense on the 2, we're going to give him 5 hit points instead. And he's going to get Colossus. No, actually fast adaptation because he's going to daggering people down. There you go, Rudolph. You're still alive after another battle, mate. Well done. Congratulations. Right, let's go down to Wollenwacht. Yeah, if I could get the mods working, if I could work out how to install them and get them running properly, I definitely have the speed mod as well. The speed mod and the pause on enemy sight are both essential for Battle Brothers. It's a shame I'm having to play it without them, really, but c'est la vie. 325 for tools. Yeah, of course. I'm going to pay that much, you fucking cunts. That's not happening. Let's go. Battle Brothers, the hunt for tools, it should be called, this game. Oh, we've done the 4 out of 4 trade suits of caravan, so we should get our ambition done now as well, which is good. Let's just let's see if it's ambush trade routes for, yeah it is, and then we'll camp till morning. No, we can't do that yet. There you go, company gains renowned, like taking candy from a child. I don't know why you'd want a child's candy, but it's still easy. Right, sell all the meat, sell the furs, sell all the crap we don't want, like all these fucking shit bucklers. What else? Oh, 1 second, guys, someone's at the door. I think it's delivery. I'll be right back. Right, guys, it was the delivery. I'm just going to take this moment to get a few refreshments. I'll be right back in just a moment. Please don't go anywhere. All right, guys, I'm back. Thank you so much for your patience. It's most appreciated. Let's dive back into where we were, shall we? Carry on killing the shit out of everything we can find, as is often the way with Battle Brothers. There's nothing we want to buy here, is there? So, let's see. We don't want these things. These tens can go, that can go. That axe we probably want to repair because it's worth more if you repair it than if you sell it now. 158 for this axe is pretty... Oh, we've got enough money, actually. I'm not going to sell anything else. Okay, let's... Any bros? Any more bros? No. 450 for a jester. Fuck that. Okay, let's go down south, see if we can find any beggars in Karakan. I hope that Karakan doesn't have ambush trade routes, because I want to buy tools and provisions and stuff there, like medical supplies and things, but if it's got ambush trade routes, we won't be able to do that. It doesn't. Good. Okay, let's see what we got. Oh, good. A cripple for 80. You're hired. That's about it, really. Maybe a shepherd for 150, but we don't really need any more bros. We need to start doing missions now. This is our kind of work. Hunt down with terrorizers. I will do that, only because I saw there's a caravan up there we can drag them into, and we can get the mission. We can kill the beasts. Oh, he's a brute. He's a shit brute, but he's a brute nonetheless. That's interesting. We can drag the caravan in, the beasts into the caravan, and that way everyone won't die. Whereas if we do it normally, everyone will die. Well, not everyone, but a lot of people will die. No, sorry, take that and come over here. You're daggering people down for armor. You can have that now, and you can have that now. You have that, you have that. Yeah. That's what I wanted to do, like that. Do we bother with a wooden flail? I don't think we do. It's a bit trash. Yeah, that's only a 30, isn't it? Whereas that's a 40. Good. Rudolph can have that because he's actually pretty decent. And he needs a better... What's that, a 20? He can have a 35. Don't care about the 20, so one of you guys can have it. That's a 10. Don't care about the 20s, so you can have that. That's a 20 anyway, isn't it? Yeah, so... Was ever. All good. Okay. Let's see if there's anything worth buying here. I don't think there will be. Two more days. Five more days. Much better. Tools are a decent price, so we're going to buy two lots. That's it, really. We don't want anything else here. Drive off nomads at 7:30. No, we're going to do this. The reason why I want to do the beasts is because it'll mean, oh good, they're going north as well towards the caravan. That's really good. We can drag them into the caravan easily, so that'll act as a meat shield for us and help kill the beasts. And on top of that, as the retinue, we can't get anyone in the retinue yet, but we want to unlock the scout as soon as possible. And the way you unlock the scout is by killing five groups of beasts. Perfect. Five hyenas. They'll come after us. We just drag them into the trading caravan. Perfect. And then we step behind the trading caravan. Where are they? Oh, they're there. Conscripts. Indebted. Ugh. They're all up here. They're all up north. Oh well, let's see what the hyenas do. Let's just wait. Hopefully the conscripts will all step forward and engage the hyenas for us. Yeah, they are good. Because hyenas could just tear through this armor, chew us to shreds, no problem. Yeah, good. They're stepping forward. We're good. Okay. Exactly what I wanted to happen is happening. That's nice. It's the first time in Battle Brothers. Now, normally you want to kill hyenas and collect their fur because the hyena fur mantle is really useful for initiative, light, nimble-based builds. But in this case, we're just not powerful enough to fight monsters and beasts yet. Yeah, at this point. We just can't kill the hyenas, so it's not worth engaging and going after them. We just want the one, the money for completing the mission, and two, the second thing we want is the scout to start being unlocked by killing beasts. We're going to maintain our position because, in fact, you're going to come down here. We're maintaining our position because we've got the high ground here, which is nice. You can come up there. You can come down here. But yeah, we don't need to worry at all. They'll kill a couple of these guys, but the conscripts will easily kill all the hyenas for us, and then we'll just get paid. Can't believe one of these guys hasn't died yet. So fucking lucky. They're rolling on 60s as well, so I might be able to nick that kill, actually. No, not quite. Very nearly. That's a shame. He can't make it. So, yeah, unfortunately, we're not going to be able to steal the kill like I wanted. Oh, there we go. Hoping to get the kill again, but I didn't. I might be able to, yeah. Got one kill. Didn't get any loot for it, but we got one kill. Whatever. Most important thing is we did the mission, so we can go back and get paid, and we got one step closer to the scout being unlocked. Which is nice. Right, let's go. Let's go where to? North again, I suppose. Back up this way, and we'll cycle. We need medical supplies because we're going to use them at some point. We're definitely going to need them. We need more tools. Let's come around this way. Let's just go back up this way and see if we can find any more mercenaries. 2,000 crowns so we can get the banner. That's like the next thing to accomplish. Past Wollenwacht and up this way to see if we can get any more, trading caravans. Why are tools so expensive here? I just don't know. So 4 days of provisions, that's fine. That's actually quite cheap for medical supplies, so I'm going to buy two lots while we're here just to get us up. You want to hover around 40 or 50. And then, yeah, let's go carry on north and see if we can... 9 more days. Let's see if we can find a supply caravan or something to kill. If not, we'll come over here. And we really need work, but none of these places have work for us. That doesn't have work. That doesn't have work. That now hates us. So we got 1, 2... We've been to Sondheim and there's nothing there for us. We've got three cities down here to get work from. That's it. And then the southern states. Oh, four, if you include Lichtmark. We need to go raiding. We don't have a choice. We can't make our money off traveling from 12 brigands. Are you fucking kidding? Actually, there's 10 of us, and some of them are poachers. Although we just run out of night time, so it is day. We'd have to move towards them. I don't like it. 12 is just a bit too many. They outnumber us, and they've got the archer advantage, and it's daytime. Let's see what's up here. 6 brigands. A marksman. A marksman, so that means there's 5 raiders. We're going to go for it, because you need to take risks in Battle Brothers. You can't just keep avoiding fights. If we die and lose, we'll have to restart, but c'est la vie. We need to try and... We need the armor. And there's only 5 of them. So we might be able to break one by daggering him down, and then there'll only be 3. I don't know. It's dodgy. It's dangerous. We'll probably lose like we lost to the... like we lost to the, what's it called, nomads. But it's make or break time. We either win this fight and we carry on the run, or we lose it and have to restart. Okay. He's just going to crossbow someone immediately. Watch. He didn't. Oh, they're being defensive as well. They will be defensive because they're going to have throwing weapons as well. That's the other part of the danger. That flail we'd like. They've all got shields as well, which really sucks, because I'm not going to be able to dagger any of them down. Like, I want, apart from him. I wanted to dagger someone down, but he's got a sword, so that's plus accuracy as well. He's dual-wielding it. Fuck. Oh, well. No, nothing to it. Just got to charge. I misclicked there. I meant to click double-click and then press finish, but I just pressed finish instead, so he's now lagging behind. Yeah, they're just going to sit there shield walling like, oh god, melons. And pull out throwing weapons and fuck us up with throwing weapons. He's got a flail, so even if we attack him with someone with a shield, he's just going to bosh us down. So fuck me, I don't even know what to do here. We are in so much trouble. They're just going to shield wall and keep throwing and shooting at us. There's no weaknesses in any of these. Maybe I should have just left. There's no weakness here anywhere. Let's wait. Well, there's no point waiting because they'll just throw more at us. Just engage with the meat shield and then let the rest of them come to us. Thank goodness that blocked. Garbage can go here. Oh, instantly dead. Yep, there we go. meat shield can go there and shield wall. There's no point because he's just going to fucking flail him down. Dead. Dead. Yeah, you see what I mean? There's just... And we were hoping for armor here. We're just not going to get it because they've got shields. Really annoying. Dead. I think it's a bit too early to be taking raiders on at this point anyway, to be honest. We just don't have the troops for it. Oh, the puncture, that was lucky. We're just going to break before we kill this lot. Oh, that was lucky. Double hit. Get the archer. Try and kill the archer and break morale. Good, his morale broke. He's going to come here now. Oh, he didn't. He went there and killed him. Yeah, go there. Block the archer down. Oh, come on. 32, and he rolls a 32 puncture. He's broken. We might just let this guy run. I think we're just going to let this guy run. He might come in for an attack, actually. Go for the head. Nice. Face shot. Yeah, he did come in. And this guy broke from it as well. Shit. Decap him to break his morale. Wait. We can't do anything, so... Stop hitting the head! I want the helmet, you prick! Oh, he had 9 lives. I didn't remember that. Dead. Dead. Hooray! We did it! Oh, God. No one's alive, but we did it! Oh, my God. Well, that culled us significantly, didn't it? Anyone survive? Oh, Roban! Yay! Roban, you survived, mate! And you're traumatized, so you got no more initiative, which means no more defense. And Meat Shield loses an ear, so he's got even less defense. So Caravan Man, Meat Shield, Garbage, and Rudolph all died. Hell of a lot of good loot for it, though. Problem is, are we going to be able to get back to town? Not with those 12 raiders behind, 12 brigands behind us. So we're going to have to come to Subingen or whatever. Right, our 3 main barbarians are still alive. Everyone else got culled, though. But we got a 3-headed flail. That'll be really helpful and useful for fighting brigands in the future. Mm-hmm. 90 armor. So, Meat Shield gets the 90 armor and 140 helmet. This guy's only got a 95, gets the 140 helmet. You can get the 110 helmet and the 80 rather than a 75. Which means you get the 75 and 105 helmet. Yay! Oh, we've got another Meat Shield here. I didn't notice that. So 65, 105 helmet. Rest in peace. Thanks, Flavius. They're resting in pieces, that's for certain. Who's got the best attack? Fucking the 64 on you with iron lungs. You can probably have the flail in that case. Boar spear, boar... Oh, no. 64, you need a boar spear. Yeah, nice. Right. He might as well have a 40 now since we got all these. Tanky Barb gets attack, defense, and initiative to make him more tanky. Gifted for even more attack, defense, and initiative. Meat Shield gets defense, initiative, and health. 9 lives. Eric the Crusher gets attack, initiative, and I would give him defense, but 1's pathetic. So he's got the flail now as well, so give him fatigue so he can keep swinging the flail at heads. Gifted for the same again. More attack, more defense, and more initiative, more defense. Yeah. Well, that certainly culled us down a bit, didn't it? Let's just save it after that. And let's come across. We can't do another battle. We need to come and hire more bros. So let's come to Subingen or whatever it's called. Subingen? Simon Balman says, no way. Hello there. Yes way, I say. Welcome, Simon. Welcome back to Battle Brothers, my friend. Thank you for joining. I hope you're well. Oh shit, we've got green skins coming down over here. I hope they got wrecked. No? Yeah, they did. They got wrecked. Good. Otherwise, we get fucked by them. Oh, we need another caravan hand because our caravan hand died. So we'll hire this guy for 250 because 250 is quite cheap and we need numbers at the moment. And he is, yeah, meh. He'll survive, hopefully. $105, $55, give him a spear and that, and yeah, all good. Camfest might have some beggars in it, so let's go to Camfest because it's a capital. It's a big citadel city, so it'll have beggars, hopefully. Perfect. Trading caravan from Varel. Yep, nice. We're going to wreck it. Okay, I don't want either of you to die to a shitty trading caravan, so you can just retreat a bit. You'll be fine in your 80 armor. You'll be fine with a shield and 65 armor. Oh, we want to dagger this guy down. 95 and 130 helmet. Yeah, you can come in. Tanky Barb can come to there. Although he needs to die. He needs to break. His morale needs to break if we're to dagger him down. Spare wall. Oh. Insta kill. Go there. He'll probably destroy the shield, but that's fine. Wait. Wait. Ouch. Fucking, of course that hits. 13 he hits. Oh, you cheeky SOB. Don't you dare do that. We need to break this guy because this guy's in trouble. Or not. Just insta-kills him. Very good. Come to here. We want to try and break this guy. Oops, meant to move there. Fuck it, Roman needs to get in there. Edit can stand by. Yeah. We might lose the caravan here, yeah. Luckily I hit the helmet, but we might lose the caravan, dude. Oh, that... No, there we go, he broke. Good. Okay, we're fine. Oops, I thought that was him. Why did I think that was him? That was stupid. Now the armor's gonna get fucked. Oh, good. It didn't get too badly damaged. Right. There you go. Job done. Got the armor and the helmet and the axe and the shield. Good. Didn't get anything but bread out of the fucking caravan, but whatever. It's a shame. Right, 130 goes on you. 95 goes on you as well. Then we got 65 goes on you. Right, we're starting to accrue a bit of equipment, so now we just need to find some bros that are worth giving it to. Yeah, basically. That can be repaired because it sells for a good amount. I think the falchions sell for a decent amount as well, but I can't remember. At any rate, we don't really have the tools to fuck around with repairing too much stuff. Yeah, we're already at max. We're already using all of our fucking tools up, so... Oh, that was lucky. I almost... If these guys hadn't caught these guys, they would have walked into us and attacked us. I didn't pause it in time. But these guys came and saved our bacon. 7 thugs and raiders would have probably wrecked us in the current situation. Yeah, because we just don't have health or armor. Lucky. Well, there's no point engaging in that. They'll be dead by the time we get to them, so... 3 peasants. Get them, boys! No, they're from Dornheim. I don't want to keep pissing off the Reds. It's not worth getting them, boys. Come on, beggars. No beggars. No beggars. I meant to go to the market. 252 for tools to buy 1. We're starting to run low on fundage. We're almost at full capacity. Well, we're at half capacity for inventory, so we want to start making our way back to Licht, whatever this is called down here, Lichtmark, to sell. Maybe we'll come to these two, actually. El Hadet and Al Anwar might have ambush trade routes themselves, in which case we could sell to them. And there also might be beggars or cripples or people we can hire. Plus, we can go through Krakendorf and Nudik to pick up work. What I might do, though, is just come up here for a bit and see if we can find any caravans to kill. Because it's on the enemy front. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you better run, peasants. Where are you running? You're running in a weird direction. Oh, 7 brigands. Thugs and raiders. We can't deal with that at the moment, unfortunately. Because we're not full health. If we were full health, I might consider it. Because you kill the thugs, and that makes the raiders waver in their morale. I'm hoping we'll be able to see if there's a caravan here somewhere. Kill the caravan and then slip back past the raiders. Looks like there are some footprints, but they're quite big. So it might be a supply caravan or an army rather than... Yeah, it's a supply caravan. We can't kill that. We're not strong enough yet. That's annoying. Oh shit, there's a fucking watchtower here. Yeah. Right, we have to retreat. We have to run. We're fucking pinned in. Go after the brigands! Get the brigands! Kill the brigands, not me. Kill each other. What the fuck? They've unified. The brigands and the soldiers are like, get them. Kill the fucking raiders. Corifia says, hello. Greetings, Caesar and company. I've watched a fair amount of your Battle Bros backlog. I'm glad to finally catch a live stream. Well, thank you so much for joining. I really appreciate it, mate. And I thank you for the support as well. I hope you enjoy. Let's get out of here. Let's go down south again. Well, that was a fucking shit fest. waste of time. We're just healing at this point anyway, so. But we need to keep making crowns. So let's come down to Krakendorf and see if we can get some work. See if we can pick up some nets here as well, like I was talking about earlier. Hunt down with terrorizers. That we can definitely do, because I just saw a caravan go past again. And for the same reasons as before, we want to do it, both for the money and for the advancement towards the scout. It's not worth buying anything here, because everything's fucking super expensive, yeah. Right, let's just do the mission. Damn it, they've gone the opposite direction to the road. Hopefully they're close. Nope, they've gone miles in the opposite direction. Oh, they're down here now. Webnecks. 7 webnecks. Right, let's take them on the road. And let's catch up with this supply caravan. Is it gone? Let it go. Come on. Don't tell me it went into Dornheim. No, it's there. Okay, good. Come down here and protect this guy. You're fine there. All good in that position. Oh, this bus is going to rotate me forward. You watch. The spiders will step here, surround him, and then he'll fucking rotate me into a position I don't want to be in. The AI always does that. They love doing that. It's so annoying. Hopefully he'll get webbed so he can't rotate. Nah. Don't want to step into a surround, so come around the edge. Same for you. You're a bit more tanky and have a shield as well as more defense, so you can go in there. What's the point in that, you weirdo? Oi! Steal the kill. And then he steps forward into it, and that's so funny. Oh my god, spiders are coming from the rear! I'm going to kill the donkey. If there's one thing I know about spiders, is that they do like a good bit of ass. Ba-dum-bum-tsh. Right. Nope. Swing and a miss. Go there. Yeah, you protect your ass. Don't want to do that. I think I'm going to have to go after this, guys. I need to have dinner, and then I might be back a bit later with Gloomhaven, depending on whether I can get my good friend and faithful companion, Kev, to come online and play tonight. If I can, if he is interested in, or if he's free and able to join, then I'll be back with Gloomhaven around 6:30, 7 o'clock. Otherwise, that'll be it for tonight, and I'll be back on tomorrow streaming more Battle Brothers some point during the day in the early hours. Not early hours, but some point in the midday to early afternoon. I'll be streaming Battle Brothers tomorrow. So, yeah, thank you all so much for joining me today. I hope you've enjoyed it. I've had fun. It's been a bit of a chaotic start. Not as quite as flawless as I would have hoped it liked it to be. Lost quite a lot of bros a minute ago in that raider fight, but we got a shitload of loot for it, a shitload of equipment, which is exactly what we needed to help bump us forward. So yeah, we're going to carry on tomorrow and just accelerate in leveling up, hunting down equipment, killing beasts to get the scout unlocked, and just carrying on in general. I hope to see you all there, guys. Thank you so much for joining today. Oh, we even got some valuables. Nice. That's good. Right, I'll just run back, drop off this contract, and I'm going to end the stream there. Flavius, congratulations once again. Huge congrats on your soon-to-be-born son. I wish you all the luck in the world. I'm sure it'll be a grand adventure, so keep us posted on how it goes. Well, I mean, we'll see you before then again, hopefully, but yeah, you'll have to keep us posted along the road. But yeah, guys, that's it for today. Thanks so much for hanging out and watching the stream. I hugely appreciate it. I hope you've all enjoyed it as much as I've enjoyed playing. If you have had a good time, be sure to click that like button and subscribe on your way out. It really helps the channel to grow and develop and get more viewership. So it means the world to me if you could support me in such a manner. But yeah, have a good night, guys. Hopefully I'll see you a bit later for Gloomhaven. That's it from me. Salway till next time.